Hello, hello, my Melodies, and welcome to all of the new Melodies and songs that have been joining our band lately. I appreciate every single one of you. I just wanted to take a moment and say, you know, welcome. This channel is pretty much just anything and everything that I like and I love, and a lot of mystery boxes. I feel like that's the gimmick that has gotten me lately, of wanting to know what's in mystery boxes, what's in mystery packs. I mean, Pokemon is a core facet of that, right? Where you just don't know what cards are in the pack until you open them. So that's what's driving me. I welcome you here. There will be lots of different content that I'm going to try and do. Got a lot of different ideas, but today I figured I would bring you guys along. I am running a league challenge. I am the professor, the head judge for the challenge, and then store owner is the organizer. But yeah, figured I would bring you along. It's going to be at the Danger Room today. I believe today is 11/11. So thank you to all the veterans. Definitely appreciate your service. My father was a veteran as well, so I understand the sacrifice well beyond the years of service and lives and all of the above. And the world is a little bit crazy right now, so we appreciate you. Just the same way that I appreciate everybody on the channel. Anyway, back to talking about the league challenge. So yeah, today is 11/11. It is, the store can only handle 32 players total. So we'll see who signs up for the different divisions. If you don't know what the league challenge means, basically it is the lowest competition tournament in Pokemon, the trading card game, where you can still earn championship points. And CP championship points allow you to, if you earn enough during a season, you can enter or you can get an invite to be able to go and play at Worlds for Pokemon. So there's the League Challenge, and then the next level up are League Cups. Those usually have more CP and are a little bit, you know, they have a top cut type of situation where it's a full tournament day. Then up from there, you go to regionals. There are all sorts of different regionals, and YouTube's. Pokemon's been doing a good job of live streaming them on YouTube and their Twitch channel. So if you ever want to check that out, go to the Pokemon channel and see what, see what the competition is like. And they usually, at that level, there's also Pokemon Go and there's Pokemon video games championships as well. So, and then there's usually side events. I like to go for some side events that are out there as well, because I like the raid format. I like some side event stuff that you can't get CP on, but I enjoy having those types of formats. So yeah, and then after regionals, you go to internationals, and then internationals, which was formerly known as nationals, but it's internationals now. Then you get to worlds. So all of those levels of play, you get more and more people who have been experienced. There's definitely like first time players at each level, except for worlds, of course, because you need the invite. But there's first time for people at worlds, but they've been in through. They've managed to get enough championship points, so you know they've had some experience. But anyway, yeah, this is the kind of the top or the bottom of the pyramid when it comes to being able to do tournaments. So if you get used to building battles, I think building battles are a great entryway into like learning how a tournament kind of is structured and played, much more relaxed and balanced. At this level, you know, you have to build your own 60 card deck. They have to be standard. For example, today, Paradox Rift did just come out last week, but the cards are not legal until 2 weeks after official release day. So I will be double-checking that nobody's using Paradox Rift cards in today's tournament. That's one of the duties of a judge. Make sure everything is fair. Make sure that if there's any questions or rulings that need to happen during gameplay, that it can follow all the different guidelines of Pokemon. So, and I really enjoy facilitating and helping everyone have a good time, because it's supposed to be fun. I know people are here to win or try and get the prizes, but it's supposed to be fun. So come along with me. I should hopefully, if the players allow me to, I'll record some of the the matches that are going on, but at the very least I'll be able to show you my setup and kind of do a highlight reel for the end of this video. And then kind of do a recap of the different prizes that are given out. Now, we're doing it where prizes are dependent on the number of attendees for each division. So we'll do the rundown of that as well. But yeah, thanks. Hopefully all that makes sense in this intro. If not, I might put the video up anyway just because. So thanks. I'll see you in a bit.